Well, just the name NF, it should be common to people say it. Like if you say NF, everyone always says, you know, what does that mean? And then you have to say neurofibromatosis. And they're like, well, what is that? And then you have to explain what it is. Bernadette is about 19 months old. She got diagnosed with NF1 at 4 months old. It's still scary not knowing what exactly will be affected with her.
It's actually really hard, you know, not knowing what could happen. You know, all the different types of things. It ranges how it affects everyone. Like Danielle has NF1 as well.
I have a very, very mild case. Now, my family is a little unique because it runs in my family line. My mom has it, my grandmother had it, my older brother has it, his son has it. And it has affected every single one of us differently. Growing up with NF1, I was teased a lot. Why do you have those spots? Why do you look different? And I don't want that to happen to her, having an adult point something out and be like, hey, come over here to their child, and then keep their child away from playing with her because they think that she has something that's contagious when she doesn't. I also had a lot of doctors that didn't know what it was. Kind of unsettling going to a doctor and they don't know what you have and how it can affect you. That was a lot of talk back and forth as to whether or not we wanted to adopt or have our own, but at least I know for me, having my own, if they ended up with NF, at least I would have the knowledge so I could be a better advocate for them with the doctors and getting them the treatment that they needed.
With NF1, everybody's different. You're never gonna know what's gonna happen, when it's gonna happen, and it's kind of like playing blind chess.
So my concerns for Bernadette are that as she goes up, she could develop different types of tumors and that they might not be treatable. And I worry that if she develops that type of tumor, she won't be able to grow up and get married and have a happy, healthy life.
Kind of watching and waiting is all you really can do. It's actually very nerve-wracking.
I want to make sure that she can go through school without feeling self-conscious about how she looks and how she walks. So my hopes are that people learn about it so she can have a normal childhood.